agenda for future action, industrial policy for emerging economy. There is a point in every scientific experiment beyond which uncertainty is reduced dramatically. The industrial policy reforms, which began out 2 decades ago, have arrived at that juncture. There are 3 key policy parameters that need to be kept in mind in designing the new economic strategy. There should be a growth in quality job. 2, the Indian economy should get strategic depth in capital goods such as power and telecom equipment. And 3, defense and security should be kept in mind. There, assume that government agencies have an understanding of India's factor endowment and comparative advantage. The political economy challenge is even more complex. Comparative advantage rapidly change in the modern economy and technology cycle are getting shorter. Policy will have to be flexible if India is not a stagnant. Agenda for action on further reforms include the following. 1, priority should be accorded to eliminate maintaining barriers to industrial production, investment and import of technology as quickly as possible. 2, the old economy dominates the Indian industry. We should not let the old economy become older. Cement, steel and textile will not vanish. Industrial policy must help rejuvenate and revitalize the old economy with the new economy tool like IT. 3, government's role should shift increasingly to restructuring unviable enterprises, ensuring fair business practices, safeguarding consumer interest and minimizing the adverse effect of industrialization on environment. 4, a successful strategy for restructuring enterprises, whether public or private, must take due account of legitimate interest of worker employed. In 3 units, more generally, we must review the reforms and current legislation for employment and industrial dispute to ensure that excessive rigidities are removed and long-term employment growth facilitated. 5, the perpetuation of regulatory measure and the imposition of inspector raj can be particularly harmful for the growth of small segment of industry. There has to be a systematic review of these regulatory measures. Success in industrial and commercial restructuring will also hinge on our ability to devise sensible policies for use of urban land. The process of industrial restructuring requires large outlay of funds, which are presently blocked in land held by many concerned units. The Urban Land Ceiling and Regulation Act 1976 has to be suitably amended to facilitate the use of this blocked resource for productive restructuring. 7, while fetters on industrial investment and production have been sharply reduced at the central government level, it is important to recognize that they are still quite pervasive in many states. The requirement for license, permit and inspection at the state and local level continue to be onerous and extract a heavy toll in terms of effort and resources from industrial units. The state government have to act as frontline implements of reforms. A recent World Bank study reports that it takes 46 days for a foreign company to set up business in India, even 7 to 14 days in US and Britain. 8, in the wake of recent reforms, the Companies Act must be rationalized and modernized. The government should change its role from that of controller to that of facilitator by making procedure transparent and eliminating delay. 9, as recently suggested by World Bank, India should revitalize the informal sector, hasten private entry into the public monopolies and promote agile firms, that is, the firm that respond quickly to changing market conditions, believing that profit cannot be made by manipulating rules and excluding competition, but by improving their global competitive capabilities. In short, By opening the economy to foreign competition, the government has indirectly urged domestic industry to become more competitive. The foreign firms that do enter the Indian market, they are typically those with a proven track record in multinational operations, a lot of dot in their disposal. The government should thus not handicap domestic firms with archaic laws, but ease of way for them to compete effectively with the foreign entrant. One goes to cricket match not just to watch good cricket, but also to see local team play well.